Sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey, and this is the fruit of it. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the sons of Anak there. We saw the sons of Anak. What is it that you saw that made you feel that what God sent you to do is impossible? It's a stronghold. We saw the sons of Anak there. Oh my God. Can you bring Goliath down? There's a Goliath in your life that must be humiliated. It's an exaggeration. An exaggeration. It must be humiliated. We saw the sons of Anak. That's what they remembered. And Acts that a captain should be consecrated to them to take them back into the land of bondage. It is only the lies of Satan that can make you at home with captivity than destiny. Garlic is a spice. It is not food. Cucumber is a vegetable. It is not food. What is it from your past that is hindering you from entering into the future? Can you assassinate it? Can you destroy it? The knowledge, the remembrance of the garlic, the remembrance of the cucumber. Before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. What is it that has casted the shadow of impossibility? That has made you believe that the circumstance is stronger than yourself. In spite of the grace of God that God has made available, in spite of the backing of God that is readily available to make you advance, can you strangle every consciousness of impossibility, every consciousness of impossibility? Oh my God, say I can do all things through Christ. That is the disposition of a believer. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can through Jesus. confess the word of God. I can do all things. I can do all things. There is no impossibility with me. Whatsoever I lay my hands upon to do, it shall prosper. I can do all things. I can do all things. Nothing can hold me down. Nothing can hold me down. I have no limitation. I cannot be disadvantaged. I can do all things through Christ. Of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof, and all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. That's an exaggeration. A land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. What exaggeration have you been working with? Meanwhile, if you board a plane and you take a flight, the building that you call big suddenly becomes small. So I found out the key to dethroning exaggeration is to exalt the Lord. Moment the Lord is exalted in your eyes, that mountain becomes small. There's a change of perspective. The mountain may not have moved, but its significance in your life is diminished. Nothing exalts God more than worship. In worship, you are blinded to the giants, the sons of Anak, You are blinded to the lies that have been exaggerated, and suddenly you begin to see things from the biceps of God. Oh. The Bible says that God is able to do. You are able. Whenever I'm faced with an impossibility, what I chant is, God is able. God is able. God is able. God is able. I go beyond myself and I begin to advertise and exalt the Lord until the Lord begins to exalt himself in my heart. There is a shift instantly. We are going to dethrone exaggerations by exalting God. Do you know that the reason why you are alive is because God is able? Do you know how many times? Oh my God, he is able. Don't give up on God. Grasshoppers, and so we were in thy sight. What is it that makes you small? You analyze and you consider yourself small, insignificant, and inconsequential. That can only be the case if you have forgotten the fact that he that is within you is greater than he that is in the world. Every stronghold that the devil builds is built on a part of truth that has been obscured. So your height is not your real height, because seated inside of you is he that is greater. So you are not 32 years old, because seated inside of you is an ancient that never began. You have access to his wisdom, you have access to his experience through the Holy Ghost. For the Bible says that the Spirit of God searches all things, even the deep things of God. So your heart does not intimidate me, because seated in me is the taller than the tallest. Seated in me is the greater than the greatest. What is it that obscures the fact that there's a spirit is involved with you? And you look at yourself and you call yourself insufficient, inconsequential. We do damage to that exaggeration. In the name of Jesus Christ. I went to preach somewhere in the southern region of Africa. And I got into the place. Maybe they expected someone bigger, but I was so lanky. And the expectation was punctured, because I don't look like someone that can command deliverances unto Jacob. And if you don't know how to manage that situation, it will make you small. But I went into the place of prayer, and the God inside of me was ready to make a statement. You know, when people despise you, that's when God rises up to defend his name on your life. Yes, sir. I came to the platform. There were thousands of people on the field. And I began to preach the gospel. I don't know how they organized it, but they put a crippled boy on the stage, so that I would not deny that I didn't see him. So what I did was I deliberately decided not to, you know, I walk on stage. I didn't walk that way. I started walking this side, preaching the gospel, preaching about the Holy Ghost. And one of those times when I turned back, the guy was shaking like a ball. He was not only born crippled, his legs were twisted and dry. He began to shake like a ball, like this. Before I knew it, he was on his feet standing. I knew that I had nothing to do with what happened. I knew it, because I couldn't tell you that it had anything to do with my faith. I didn't believe the boy could walk, so I limited my motion from the pulpit. I go this side. So what was happening there, I had nothing to do about. And the guy rose up. And the mother began to roll on the ground, because he has never walked. He was 9 years old. The moment the guy began to take steps, 5 other people that were using crutches got angry with their crutches, threw them away, and began to walk. And I also did not have anything to do with the guys that were walking, that threw their crutches away. It was their own faith that was at work. I was a spectator like every other person on the field. Do you know what happened? The crowd ran to touch my clothes. So the police now arrested me and took me in their van to my resting place. We were not supposed to have any service that evening again. It was just a morning service. By evening, So,
and the mother began to roll on the ground because he has never walked. He was 9 years old. The moment the guy began to take steps, 5 other people that were using crutches got angry with their crutches, threw them away, and began to walk. Began to walk. And I also did not have anything to do with the guys that were walking, that threw their crutches away. It was their own faith that was at work. I was a spectator like every other person on the field. Do you know what happened? The crowd ran to touch my clothes. So the police now arrested me and took me in their van to my resting place. We were not supposed to have any service that evening again. It was just a morning service. By evening, uncountable numbers of people have trooped out of the villages. Trooped out of the villages in Zambia, villages in Tanzania. They have put sick people in wheelbarrow. And they have journeyed for 2 days to meet the evangelists, the healing evangelists that came to Nigeria. They had to call me and beg me that even though you don't have a session again, they are gathered. They are gathered. So, you know what happened? When I left the place, the hand of God was still on the meeting. And the seat that I sat on the stage, the people joined a straight line, then they'll give you like 2 minutes to sit on the seat. And a woman sat on the seat and she began to prophesy accurately. And they were writing her utterances. People were sitting and getting healed. People were touching the pulpit and getting healed. Oh, the angel of healing was standing there and the healing balm was flowing out. They say, bring the Nigeria, bring the Nigeria, bring the Nigeria. And when I came, I saw the crowd. That was when I started seeing crowd. I saw the crowd and the only thing I did was to say, in the name of Jesus. The miracles. That was all I did. That was all I did. In the name of Jesus. And blind eyes began to open. Deaf ears began to hear. Crippled people began to stand up. People carried in the wheelbarrows began to shake and began to walk. The police had to arrest me again. Me, myself, I was amazed because all of my preaching in Nigeria, I've never seen that kind of thing. So I had to go to one and say, what are you doing? A spirit is involved. It's not your, oh my, it's not about you. Healing. We left the ground. Healing continued until midnight, 2 a.m. You know, I tell you people, it's only in Makurdi I'm not strong. Yeah, it's only here. We went for baptism. The guys that gave their life to Christ, 200 and something people. So we took them for baptism to the river. And we began to sing. And the song was in their language. I didn't even understand it. And the Holy Ghost, His presence came through the song. Then when I entered into the water to start baptism, the Lord spoke to me and said, today is Bethsaida. So, and I know the place, I know the scripture. That was how God began to heal with the water. He healed from 12 o'clock to 4 p.m. in the evening. With water. I left the place, I said, what is happening? So when we were going back, you know, when I arrived their headquarters, the airport, they took me to one guy. He had a scan that his muscles were torn. I saw the scan. I prayed for him. Before I went to the village, did the crusade, came back, he went for another scan, and the muscles were replaced. I saw it with my eyes. I saw it with my eyes. From that day, and it was not as if the anointing on me increased or I felt the presence of God in an unusual way. No, I knew this was not me. This was God. This was not even the angels that walked with me. with me. This was an angel that was deployed directly from heaven that was doing that, those miracles. When I went back to ask God, God now said, there are angels that work with your ministry and there are angels that work by his own directive. That he just sent one of the angels that worked by his directive and that was the one working. It's not even the angels that work with me. That a day will come in the future when that angel will be permanently stationed. Yes, he told me about that day. And healings of all kinds, miracles of all kinds will begin to take place. See, God is confirming it. Hallelujah. The miracles of all kinds will begin to take place. From what I see in the spirit, he wants to start this year. From what I see. It's not about you. Who are the sons of Anak? Who is Goliath before God? Somebody is coming out already. You are coming out already. You are coming out already. I was on my way back. And when, what happened? Okay, my driver, we got to the headquarters of that country. I don't want to mention the country. So that they'll take me to the airport. But my flight was 11 o'clock in the night. We got to the headquarters from the village by 7 o'clock in the evening. So my driver now said, man of God, can I take you to my father-in-law's house so that you bless them? I said, okay, why not? We got to the place. When we got to the place, his father-in-law was deaf. His mother-in-law was crippled. So I now went to the father-in-law because they have a way of speaking to him. I said, Jesus, then they will do that. Wants to open your ear, then they'll lie. Alright? Then I went to him that I want to pray, then they do like this. I had not started praying, I just put my hand on the ear, then the ear is now open. The man said, I can hear. You can what? We have not prayed. He stood up. I can hear. Yeah. And then he began to dance without music. I was expecting his wife to stand up and dance with him. Then I realized she couldn't walk. So I now reasoned in myself. I said, okay, if God healed this one, this is my meal. If God healed this one, it means God. So I now went to the woman. This one, I was not led to. It's my calculation. I said, if God healed this one, God will. That's why I went to the woman and said, the Lord Jesus, whom I serve, says you walk. Meanwhile, that instruction I gave, there was fear in my heart. I just spoke. I said, the Lord Jesus, whom I serve, says you walk. Then I held her hand, she fell down. Then the remaining faith, in fact, the faith left. It was just one strand. And people were already watching. Then I raised her up. When I raised her up, I pushed her. She staggered. And the woman began to walk. She began to walk. Guess what? My driver began to cry. The first son of the house now came into the sitting room and spoke in his heart and said, all these false prophets. He said it in his heart. I heard it live, like a voice. And I went to him and said, you call me false prophet. He denied. I touched him. He fell under the power. All of this. That was the first time I saw real food. It was in their house. Because where I went to preach, oh my God, you don't need that food. They said, I should come and eat. I said, it's already time for my flight. The man says, see, can you come into my room? Just lie on the bed so that I will know that some of what you carry will be on my bed. The driver was driving me to the airport crying. When we got to the airport, there were military people everywhere, and they saw that the man was crying. They arrested me. They said, why did I make their citizen cry? And then the man started crying more. I didn't say anything. I was arrested. When he had finished crying, he now told them that all of them are in trouble. that this man that they arrested, he opened the ears of his father-in-law just now and caused his mother-in-law to walk this evening. It was from there he had been crying. Hey! The military people did like this. I'm telling you, all these things happened at the airport. It was through armed military men with escort that they escorted me to the plane. Armed men. When I sat on the plane, people were sleeping. I couldn't sleep. I was asking God, okay, what just happened now? It's not about you. It's not about you. It's not about you. It's about the Holy Spirit of the living God. It's not about you. It's about the Holy Ghost. Greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. Somebody needs to rejoice in the Lord Jesus Christ. I have mighty expectations concerning your life that during the course of this year, you will go beyond the limitations that have held you bound in the name of Jesus Christ. I came back home humbled. The reason why you have not heard this story is because I didn't have any release to tell it for years. In the place of prayer, God told me that is the realm of healing that I'm taking you into. That's your future. I just showed you a glimpse that it's not by power. It's not by might. It is by the Spirit. By the Spirit. By the Spirit. Now, we're going to do something in the next 2 minutes. You just speak in tongues for 2 minutes. Just for 2 minutes. Oh, my God. Those of you online, follow in. Just speak in tongues for 2 minutes. 2 minutes. The hand of God is strong here. The hand of Jesus is strong. The hand of Jesus is strong. Sabose salito combre. Sagaito cantelia. Resco filamando. Ore canceli. Ore cansamalanda. Ore caguria. Ore casamateli. Adabro scontelli. Adabro santelli. Adabro comberando. Esco sila. Esco sabalanda. Esco conda. Ela bonde. Ela sabalite. Nica branda babola. Ecadia tete. Of you a favor. That you will convince everyone in this hall that you are greater than their fears. You are greater than the witches that have resisted them. You are greater than the barricades that have stood before them in destiny. That you will prove to everyone here and everyone online, oh my God, the testimony of your might, the testimony of your mighty hand, the testimony of the ability of your spirit. That during the course of this year, you will do that which they never expected. In the name of Jesus. Found the wisdom of the wise. Do incredible things beyond our imagination in the name of Jesus.
little one to become a thousand. Cause a small one to become a strong nation. Even those among us that are small, cause, oh God, their lives to increase in the name of Jesus Christ. When they shall say there is a casting down, put a song on our lips that we might sing that there is a lifting up in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.